so I'm going to talk a little bit about how we as individual people can get involved in doing that work on the ground. I am not a libertarian, and I've heard that there are a lot of people at this conference who also don't identify as libertarians, so I'm in good company. I actually came to anarchism through social justice. I was a teenage social justice warrior way back before there was such a thing as Tumblr. And as a social justice warrior, I have to point out that we are a panel of three white people up here talking about prison abolition, and so there's some really important perspectives on this conversation that aren't being represented. But I just want to take a moment to write that. Space that I'm not here in this conversation. So you know, throughout my life, I have gotten involved in a bunch of sort of different movements, restorative justice, is similar to transformative justice. It's sort of ways of thinking about ways we might preempt the way that the sentencing process works, anti-racist activism, queer liberation work, social anarchism. Ultimately, all of these things lead to prison abolition. And it was a bit of a hard concept for me to grasp when I started out. I mean, it feels very intense, like, what do we do? What do we do if we don't have prisons? What do we do with the murderers and the rapists and the pedophiles and all of this? And I think that it's, I was really appreciating Chair Weidman's talk this morning, because even though I think there's been some great suggestions about kind of like what are some things that could replace the prison system, the real issue is that the thing we're doing now doesn't work. It's not preventing crime. It's not making communities safer. It's basically, it's only making things worse, and it's not solving the problems that it claims to solve. And so I feel like the question that when people ask, how can we get rid of prisons? What else did we do? Well, the answer is, we may not know, but what we're doing now isn't working, so we have to try something else. And we've all been immersed in this context of state violence all our lives. And so it's hard for us to look outside of the context and really imagine what might it be like to live in a world where state violence is not the solution to crime or to interpersonal violence. But we're not going to be able to come up with a solution by just sitting around and talking about it until we find this perfect utopian ideal. We have to just try some stuff. So one of the things that I have been trying over the past couple of years with some other collaborators, one of them being Maymay, who's here today, is trying to use new technologies to build some non-state alternatives for community justice and crisis response. So just as a couple of examples of these, the one that's gotten the most press is, actually you see the whole slide here. This is a predator alert tool. It's a software that exists for a bunch of different social networking sites. The two ones that I most primarily want to talk about here are the one that exists for Facebook. There's also a predator alert tool for a site called FetLife, which is kind of like a BDSM fetish social network dating site. And these are tools that allow people who have been victims of sexual violence to communicate with other people in their communities about their experiences. The one that was built for FetLife is specifically, because it's kind of a small community that uses the site anyway, it's a way for people to be able to like let the whole website know, hey, this is the experience that I had with this person at this time. The one that exists for Facebook, because Facebook tends to be more, lots of these kind of like atomic small social networks that are connected to each other, it allows people to say, I, as a survivor, had an experience and I want to be able to connect with other people in my social community who've had an experience with the same person. So I can say, I went to this party, this person put a drug in my drink. I don't want to talk about this publicly, but I do want to talk to anybody else who has had a same experience with that same person. So I can post a little thing, and it'll only be shown to other people who have posted a similar, made a similar comment about that person. It takes advantage of Facebook's granulated privacy settings in some various ways. So, and these are all experiments. They're very beta. They're very proof of concept, but they're ways for people to sort of think about how might we talk about our experiences of sexual violence and building community support. support and resourcing around preventing and recovering from sexual violence in ways that don't involve calling the police, which is typically not a system that's very helpful to survivors of sexual violence. Anyway, the tool that we're working on right now is called Better Angels, and the specific packaging of Better Angels GUI is built for a domestic violence use case. But this is a community-based emergency crisis response app, and so the idea is that I, as a user, would have this on my phone. I set up the people that I want voluntarily on my crisis response team. So I say, if I'm in an emergency situation, I don't want to call 911. I want to call my brother, my best friend, this friend of mine who moved down the street who's like a black belt in karate, and somebody I know who is like really sort of trained in medical care, and the advocate I know who works at the local shelter. So I set up my own team. And then if I'm in a crisis situation, I just have one click, I hit the button, this alert goes out to all the people in my network. They get an alert saying, Rebecca's in crisis. I can put a little message so I can say like, my house is on fire, or like I'm being harassed by the cops or whatever. They get a message, it shows them where I am, a map, where they are in relation to me, where any other responders are in relation to them, and it drops everybody into a little chat room so that people can coordinate a response. So they can say, okay, I see on the map that you're the closest person to Rebecca, why don't you go over there and see what she needs? I'm gonna go to the school and pick up her kids. This person can go to the hospital and like, or this person can go to the Walgreens and get some Band-Aids or whatever it is needed. So again, this is just an experiment. This one is in development right now. But these are both examples of a larger concept, which I also can't show you the whole slide for. this idea that we've been playing with as software development as a form of direct action. So, we've probably all heard a lot about hacktivism and anonymous, going around and using things and, breaking into the FBI website or whatever. And there's a very anarchic element to this kind of like burn and destroy hacktivist thing. But there's also, I think, an anarchic element to an idea of using technology as a way to build alternative community mechanisms. And so these are just a couple of experiments that I think, but there's a lot more out there, and I wish there were a ties into the talk that we're going to see later today, and And so their law project, as Nathan mentioned, is the phase organization. They mostly work on supporting transgender, gender non-conforming prisoners, and they also have a prison abolition base. And then just a shout out, because I know there's some other people from New Mexico here. Free Spook is a little prison abolition group that's based out of Albuquerque that's doing some just like really, really like hands-on. They have a specific person they're trying to get a retrial for, and they're just kind of trying to do education about prison abolition and the prison system and solitary confinement specifically in the New Mexico area. The picture that I showed earlier of the little ofrenda, that was something that they put together for the Day of the Dead celebration, and they just do some outreach and education. So if you're in Albuquerque or anywhere in New Mexico and you want to get involved, look at their website. And that's about it. Thanks very much, and feel free to drop me an email if you have any questions.